Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about hyperopia, also known as farsightedness. So stay tuned as we dive in. Okay, so what is farsightedness? What is hyperopia? What does it mean when you're farsighted and can happen to see pretty far away or prefer to see far away? So follow me along on the picture we're about to show you as we describe this in detail. So in the picture you see right here, we're going to have light rays, just like the picture of nearsightedness, coming into the eyeball. But what happens is as light passes through the cornea and the lens, it doesn't quite focus on the retina or the macula, as you can see here. Technically, if the light were to continue beyond the retina, it doesn't. But let's say it does. It would focus at a point behind the retina. So how's that happen? Well, it doesn't, because the light doesn't quite make it there. What does a farsighted patient or a hyperopic patient do? The crystalline lens changes shape for most patients that are under the ages of 40 to 45 to 50. Once you get around those ages, it looks a little different. We'll talk about that in a few minutes. So what happens is the crystalline lens changes shape, and it brings that focal point right onto the macula. So if you can kind of picture moving that little dot over to the macula and retina, that's what allows someone to see far away and up close. The act of doing this is a term that we like to call accommodation. Accommodation is the eye's ability for the crystalline lens in order to be able to move that focal point to line up on the retina. This means that if you have been diagnosed with farsightedness, hyperopia, whatever it may be, your eyes live in a constant state of fluctuation to get that point clearly focused on the retina. Now, as I mentioned a few moments ago, what happens when you're 40, 45, or 50, or at least those ages for the most part? Well, the crystalline lens typically hardens around those ages just due to time, birthdays, genetics, you name it, and it doesn't focus light very well anymore, which means someone who once was able to focus for the first few decades of their life is not able to really focus that well anymore, which means they need something in the possibility of farsighted driving reading glasses. Distance vision. When I say reading glasses, I mean that's just distance vision. Reading glasses up close are a separate issue involving the crystalline lens because of the eye's inability to focus. That'll be covered in another video. But this is what farsightedness is, also known as hyperopia, when your doctor talks to you about this. Your eyes have to constantly move that focal point, and they live in a constant state of fatigue in order to be able to do that, which if you wear the prescription glasses, contact lenses, things of that nature, it makes it a lot easier on your eyes to focus and see clearly, both far away and up close. Be sure to subscribe to the channel in order to stay up to date on the latest content we release and new topics we talk about. And if you have any new topics or new suggestions or things you'd like for us to cover, drop it in the comments below and we'll get to it. I'm Dr. Bryce Heffington, and we'll see you next time.